Good morning, students. In this session, we are going to discuss about various construction equipments, the technical terms related to the same, and together we are also going to study about various soil properties, because you are going to move your equipment on earth, that is on soil. So when you are considering any type of construction equipment, you also have to take into account various soil properties. These are the properties, fundamental definitions, which you have actually studied in soil mechanics and geotechnics. So we shall go through it once, and then we will jump to fundamental technical terms related to equipments, and further the basic equipments used for construction procedure. Let us start. As you can see, this is a basic picture consisting of all different type of construction equipment specifically related to excavation or leveling or laying foundation trenches or transportation or landscaping, right? Out of all these pictures, most of you are familiar with most type of equipments. All of you have seen these equipments on site as well. The thing is, you are going to name all these type of equipment specifically and study about the technical terms related to the same, its purposes, advantages, disadvantages, and the type of equipment to be selected when you are dealing with different types of soil. As you can see here, you are familiar with the excavator, dumping truck, forklift, mobile crane, tower crane, bulldozer, roller. All of these equipments are seen by you somewhere or other. You just have to study about its specific names. When I talk about excavator, the first idea that pops into your mind is JCB. Correct. But JCB is just a manufacturing company. Here you are going to study that what are the basic names of the equipments which you are already familiar with. Let us move further. Let us start. What is moving earth? As I said, moving earth means you are moving or excavating large amount of soil for purposes of laying foundation trenches or excavation or landscaping or say trial pits or pits for basement. There are various numerous purposes for which you have to carry out the excavation work. So, as you know, heavy duty equipments are required. All of these equipments are heavy duty, and depending on the quantity of material, time constraints, the specifications, or say the type of material you are excavating, its size, its individual pieces, etc., everything will be contributing towards the selection of type of equipment. Let us start with soil properties. So, as you know, all of these properties are studied by you already in soil mechanics and geotechnics, as I mentioned earlier. So, we will move a little fast with these properties. Start with compressibility. As you know, compressibility means when you apply compressive force on soil, the reduction in its volume expresses the compressibility. Next, elasticity. Every one of you know what is elasticity. Let us say for black cotton soil or say clay soil, it has the tendency to undergo elastic deformation and then it returns back to its original state partially, that is elasticity. Next, capillarity refers to the capillary pores of soil. Shearing resistance refers to the shear resistance, resistance to shear force or compressive force. Internal friction, I'll give you one example over here. In internal friction, if you move a bulldozer or say tractor on sandy soil, the soil particles tend to move away from each other, while this is not the same case for cohesive soil. So this is due to internal friction. Next, cohesion. Cohesion means the soil particles remain one. Shrinkage, due to loss of water due to evaporation, soil can undergo large amount of shrinkage, and vice versa, it can also undergo large amount of swelling. Next, consolidation. When you apply compressive force on fully saturated soil, its water tends to move out after certain amount of force, that is consolidation. Permeability, that is the property of the soil which allows the water to move under the effect of gravity. Settlement due to compressive force, the reduction in elevation of soil is settlement. So why do you need to consider these properties? Because you have to find out what is the effect that you are going to face by, say, moving an excavator, or say by moving a roller or dumper. So you have to study what are the effects that you are going to face while selecting your construction equipment. Let us move further to fundamental definitions. These are the terms which you have already studied twice in your previous academic semesters. First is your water content, that is amount of water held by the soil. Go to bulk unit weight. Unit weight and volume are equivalent. When you consider mass, it is volume. When you consider weight, it is unit weight. So if you consider total weight upon total volume, that gives you bulk unit weight. If you consider dry soil solids weight by total volume, dry unit weight. Similarly, saturated unit weight and submerged unit weight. Now you talk about unit weight of solids, then here you are considering total weight of only soil solids by volume of soil solids and not the total volume. Specific gravity, which is in turn familiar with everyone, void ratio and porosity, and last, degree of saturation. For fully saturated soil, degree of saturation will be equal to 1, that is 100%, and for dry soil it will be 0. Alright, let us move further to fundamental terms related to equipments, starting with the first, rolling resistance. Now what is rolling resistance? So as your vehicle or equipment moves further, resistance is encountered in the opposite direction, right? That resistance caused by a vehicle while moving over a road or surface in opposite direction of its traveling is called rolling resistance. Rolling resistance is expressed in kg, right? It depends on various factors. Now what are the factors? Absolutely, you would know that it depends on the surface on which it is traveling, right? The surface should be, it can be either hard surface or soft soil or moist soil or marshy land. Depending on different factors, you will get different amounts of rolling resistance. Next, grade resistance. Now when I talk about grade, it relates to slope, correct? Now when you are moving your vehicle towards a slope, let us say the slope is rising. So the force which opposes the movement of the equipment or machine in the opposite direction on a slope is called grade resistance, right? As it is clear, it acts against the total volume or total weight of the machine. Now, if I say if the slope is going downwards, you will call it grade assistance. Now, here, observe the picture very clearly. The vehicle is moving in upward direction. The slope is actually increasing slope, right? So here, the total weight of the equipment will be acting in downward direction. And the two components, normal and sine alpha, are shown here. The angle which is made by the slope with the horizontal is alpha. So let us say, how do you define grade resistance? So grade resistance or percentage grade is defined as, with every increase in elevation vertically, with every 1 foot of slope in vertical direction, per 100 feet of horizontal distance, right? The slope where the surface rises by 1 foot vertically per 100 feet of horizontal distance is called grade resistance or percentage grade. How do you find total grade resistance? That is equal to the total weight of the equipment multiplied by 10 alpha. So now if you consider alpha angle, then your 10 alpha will be equal to the vertical distance, that is consider 1 foot, and the horizontal distance, that is 100 feet. This gives you grade resistance. This is valid for angles alpha less than 10 degrees. Next, coefficient of traction. Now let me clear, what is actually tractive force? Tractive force is the force that causes motion of a body. Now if you want to cause a motion of the body, you have to apply some force. That force is called tractive force. Now the high amount of, how much higher tractive force you are providing, that will be giving you maximum output of the equipment. So now, how do you define coefficient? That means you have to multiply a constant. You have to determine that how much amount of constant or maximum value which you will multiply with tractive force gives you coefficient of traction. Higher the coefficient of traction, higher the chances of not causing slippage of your vehicle. So as it is clear, it will be different for all different type of road surfaces. It will be different for gravel, it will be different for concrete roads, it will be different for bituminous, it will be different for ice. Higher the coefficient of traction, higher is the chance that your vehicle will not slip. Next, rim pull and drawbar pull. So rim pull actually designates the tractive force between the tires and the surface. Here I explained what is tractive force. It is a force that causes motion of the body. And how is this force designated? With the help of a new term called rim pull. Next, drawbar pull. That is the towing force, right? You have to draw the load. You have to draw the amount of load. So that towing force which causes the pull, which tows your force, that is called drawbar pull. So, I hope you are clear with these fundamental definitions. For the next lecture, for the next session, I will continue with the basic equipments, tractor, bulldozer, rippers and scrapers. Thank you. Hello students. Now, let us get back to where we stopped. Last time I discussed about various fundamental definitions and terms related to soil and construction equipments, right? So today we are moving further with the basic equipments. Let us say we start with the first one, that is tractors. Now everyone of you is familiar with a tractor. Everyone has seen a tractor. Everyone has seen the working of tractors, right? So let us discuss about the same, its types, its classification and how it is useful for our construction procedure. So as you can see the image, a tractor is mounted either on wheels or on crawler. Yes, a tractor can be wheel mounted or crawler mounted. So for the wheel mounted, the front wheels are smaller in size and the rear wheels are larger in size. Here you can see the tractor is mounted with a bulldozer blade. So here this is used for excavating and loading the amount of soil and then transporting it to elsewhere. So first we will discuss about tractors and then we will move further to various equipments. So as you know, tractor is a versatile or let us say a multi-purpose machine. Okay, what is the main purpose? That is to push or pull heavy loads, medium loads, light loads. It may be of different material, excavated material, soil, aggregates, etc. Classification, as I said, tractor can be either wheel mounted or crawler mounted. So there are various advantages and disadvantages of these two different type of tractors. Now if I say wheel mounted tractors can travel longer distances as compared to crawler mounted. But if you say wheel mounted tractors provides less power as compared to crawler mounted. So crawler mounted tractors are more powerful machines as compared to wheel mounted. If we talk about maintenance and repair, so crawler mounted tractors, its blades will get wear out very fast. So you have to replace it periodically. Hence the maintenance and repair cost will increase with crawler mounted as compared to wheel mounted. So there are various points of discussion where you can differentiate between wheel mounting and crawler mounting. Correct? Next, let us discuss about factors. What are the factors that affect the selection of type of tractor? Yes, it should be very clear. It depends on the type of soil or the type of surface on which you are moving. Next, the amount of load which you want to transfer. Next, the type of material which you want to transfer. Yes, there are numerous factors on which the selection of tractors depend. As I said, I already discussed the difference, that is also an important question, difference between wheel mounted and crawler mounted. Let us move next. As you can see, this is your wheel mounted tractor and this is your crawler mounted tractor. Let me say one more point of discussion or difference. Wheel mounted tractors are operated by steering, while the crawler mounted tractors are operated using a stick with steering. Talking about the line diagram which you are supposed to draw, you have to show the wheel tractor and crawler tractor, as you can observe over here. Second equipment, that is bulldozer. Every one of you is familiar with the word bulldozer. Okay, so what is the main purpose of bulldozer? As I discussed about the purpose of your tractor, so here bulldozer's purpose is, it is actually designed for cutting and pushing material over short distances. So here bulldozer will be used for short distance. It is actually a dozer blade which is used for cutting the material, loading it in the bucket and then transferring it over another surface. What does it consist? It is a tractor with a front mounted blade, as I said already, okay, and different depth of cut and rate of leveling can be achieved with the bulldozer depending on material and application. Next, bulldozers can be either wheel mounted or crawler mounted. If it is crawler mounted, special clearing blades are attached to rip the rocks also. Purposes, as I said, you can use it for cutting and pushing material, you can use it for ripping of rocks, you can also use for different depth of cut below its level. There are different purposes of bulldozer. Classification, as I said, it may be wheel mounted, it may be crawler mounted, and the third type should be, it can be manually operated, it can be hydraulically operated. Let us discuss about the parts. As you can see, this is the line diagram which you are actually supposed to draw. It is a crawler mounted bulldozer. It consists of, at the front part, its engine. Next, as you can see, is the pulley block and wire rope through which, with the help of anchor hook, your blade is attached. Blade has a cutting edge at its bottom. Blade is attached with your crawler with the help of pusher arm, and this way your procedure can be done. Next, the image which you saw previously, the line diagram, this one shows the real image of the crawler mounted bulldozer. Let us move to next equipment. I already discussed about tractors, then I discussed about bulldozer. Now, third, I am discussing about scrapers. So what is a scraper? Again, scraper is actually one type of dozer, right? Scraper is also a dozer, but what is the difference? Here scrapers are used with the capacity of 3 to 9 meter cube. So the capacity of scrapers can be a little more as compared to bulldozer, and there is one specification: scrapers can be used for digging earth up to 250 mm depth, right? Rest of the parts for the scraper will be same, except the cutting edge and its teeth and its bottom, while the purposes remain the same. What is the movement or operation for scrapers? So the blade or the cutting edge cuts the ground, and then loosened material is collected in the body of the scraper or say bucket of the scraper, and then it is taken out by opening the bottom of it. So simultaneously the procedure is, you have to dig it, you have to convey it and dump it. Digging, conveying and dumping. Classification of scraper, it comes in two different types: pusher loaded and self loading. Now, advantage and disadvantage, as you can see, you can write from its theory itself. What are the disadvantages? That it can dig earth only up to 250 mm depth. Second, you cannot go for heavy hard rocks and boulders with the scrapers. You can do it for soft rocks or soft soil or moist soil, can be done with the help of scrapers. While if you talk about advantages, you can have capacity of 3 to 9 meter cube. You can travel for longer distance as compared to tractors. So by theories, you can write down its advantages and disadvantages. Line diagram for scraper. This is a cross section. Actually, if you cut your scraper from center, this shows your cross section. Here, as you can see, starting from left shows your engine and the controls and the driving wheel. Then comes your hoist line and apron, and next comes your bowl. All these things are attached to the scraper. This shows your parts of the scraper. This takes the procedure or completes it the procedure with the help of scraping the material, that is removing the material, taking it into the bowl or bucket and then dumping it elsewhere. As you can see, this is a real image of a scraper. As I said, it has only one sharp cutting edge or one teeth, as I said mentioned earlier, and this is a crawler mounted scraper. It can be crawler mounted, it can be wheel mounted. Next, we are going to talk about rippers. Now, scrapers and rippers are actually the same equipments but with different sharp cutting edges. Now, this equipment is attached again to a tractor or a crawler, but now here it will carry 2 to 4 teeth, right? Scraper was carrying one sharp cutting edge, here it will be 2 to 4. In most cases, ripper consists of 3 sharp edges or 3 cutting edges. Now, as I said, there was a drawback for scraper. It could only scrape stiff clay or soft rock, while rippers can excavate from hard rocks also. So, there are also types called rock rippers. Okay, you can also call it ripper dozer. This is your image of ripper. It can be scraper dozer, it can be ripper dozer, you can call it rock rippers or rippers. There are various names for the same. Alright, students, so this clears your basic excavating equipments. For the next time, I will come up with the excavating equipments. Thank you.